Hello, everyone. Happy Monday. I know Monday isn't usually a happy day, but hopefully yours has been made a little bit happier by the stream happening. Of course, if you're not watching live, then it's not Monday, probably. So happy whatever day it happens to be. I wanted to start off the stream with a bang. Indulge in a little braggadocio, because I had probably the best daily challenge run the best daily challenge run I've ever had a couple days ago on the 12th. Bam! Number 113, 217,000 gold out of a total of 6,200. So pretty good. I'll probably never crack the top 100 until I'm really able to start doing the hell runs confidently. But for someone who's sort of fair to middling at Spelunky, I felt pretty proud of that one. Hello to Bippo Ernesti in the chat room, who's going to be playing Dungeons of Dreadmoor while watching the stream. So I wish you good luck. That's a really good way to play roguelikes while watching or listening to something else. Hello to Bin020. I'm not getting any sound. He sounds okay for me. It's Bippo's wires. Okay. Good. Hopefully everything looks and sounds good. I think I finally gotten to the point where I can just confidently start the stream without having to fiddle with all kinds of dumb video and audio settings on my end. But yeah, I would not have been able to put in the 100 or so hours I put into Spelunky if it weren't for streams and LPs and podcasts and stuff that I listen to in the background. I should probably just play Spelunky in a window and have the video off to the side so I can look over and watch when something exciting happens. Like right now, I'm listening to a Dark Souls stream, which has been pretty entertaining. The guy playing the game is really, really bad at it, but he has a good attitude, which, you know, I can't say much because, you know, I'm terrible at Dark Souls as well. But when something exciting starts happening, which, let's face it, isn't that often, I have to alt-tab out and then alt-tab back to Spelunky after viewing the exciting thing. So if I just have the video, like, in a window, that'd probably work out better. But yeah, definitely a good way to play these kinds of games. A lot of the time I put into Binding of Isaac, I did that as well. Listening to podcasts on the side. So yeah, I already took a hit here. I practiced a little bit before the stream started. Hopefully, got all the really terrible runs out of my system. I didn't even make it past the jungle in my previous streams. I had no idea Duke is still in the business, found him by accident on Twitch. Oh yeah, I'm in the business. Business is booming, baby. Okay, not really. But I did hit 200 followers on Twitch, which is a pretty good milestone for me, considering I was stuck at 190-something for like a year. Ah, crap. I'm never going to be able to get a bomb through that hole. And if I do, I'm probably going to knock the spider off the ceiling. I should probably just run past, but I would like to get sticky bombs. I've noticed that if I don't get sticky bombs in the mines, the run usually does not go that well for me. Because the odds of finding it, like in a crate, are pretty slim. And shops don't really sell it that often. And even if they do sell it in a shop, I'm trying to save my money to buy the Ankh and other more necessary items. Yet at the same time, sticky bombs are pretty vital, especially in the later levels. Oh, crap. Like, I did manage to get to Olmec in a run the other day without sticky bombs. The way I killed Anubis was pretty ridiculous, because I was still trying for the Hell Run at that point. And without sticky bombs, Anubis is a real pain in the ass to deal with. Crap. I was hoping he would be down here. So, it was a dark level too, which made things even more fun. Oh, there it is. So what I ended up having to do was, I sort of ran Anubis around in a circle and just threw the torch at him over and over again, because that was the only projectile I had. And of course, you know, Anubis takes two bombs to kill, which one bomb, I don't know how many hits that's worth with an item or a whip or whatever, but it's a lot. And it took me so long to kill him that the ghost spawned. So it was sort of like an old slapstick comedy movie with like three people chasing each other around in a circle. But, you know, none of them realize if they just turn around, then they'll be able to catch the person they're chasing. So it was kind of like that. Like, Anubis and the ghost were both... Or I was chasing Anubis, the ghost was chasing me, and I don't know how I made it through that alive, but I eventually did. And I made it to Olmec without sticky bombs. But I died. One of those bird people threw me right under Olmec's stomping path. Oh, Missy Shade. I just love your LPs, especially the Lost Vikings Gam through. Well, thank you. Lost Vikings is still probably the most popular thing I've done on YouTube. Which isn't surprising, because I had two awesome people playing through that one with me instead of just myself. Or with just Moors, as most of the other LPs are. Crap. Maybe I can trick that spider into setting off that trap for me. Oh wait, it already was set off. Okay. Steam always starts downloading shit when Duke streams. Yeah, Steam does tend to do that at inopportune times. The real pain in the ass is that Steam always seems to be downloading games I don't play. Like, it starts downloading a huge patch for Path of Exile, but I haven't played that game in a few weeks now. And I should just delete it, but you never know. I might get the itch again. Although lately Spelunky has been taking up most of my gaming time. I did start playing Dark Souls just to try it out, because I've been watching like a ton of footage of that game, and I figured I should at least give it a shot. Hello, Galen. Missy Shade says, Spelunky is still in my backlog, not enough free time, but there is Twitch. Yeah, I think that's kind of how I am with Dark Souls. Like, I'd really like to play through that game, but that might be a game I'll just experience vicariously. Camera. I do like the camera, because you can kill bats with it. Well, if you can get it in the bright zone. But I don't know, it's not good enough to juggle with all the other items you want to use. But yeah, I started playing Dark Souls, and I didn't make it very far. I played about 4 hours or so. And right now I'm at a part where I basically have three options as to what I can do next, and they all involve killing something that I'm not skilled enough to kill yet. So not really sure if I'll go back to it. I do really enjoy the combat in that game. Just feels really good. But it's also really goddamn tough, so I don't know. Like, the area I'm in, I've gotten down pretty well, like, as far as just killing the trash mobs go. So I can make it through the trash mobs without having to use, only using, like, one or two of my 10 flasks. But then, there's a boss I can kill called the Taurus Demon. Or there's another guy with, like, big, like, this huge club that he attacks you with. And he's, like, wearing really heavy armor. And another enemy, I think it's the Black Knight. I'm not 100% sure. He sure looks like a Black Knight. And I know I've heard that phrase used in the context of Dark Souls before. Gotta go to bed quite late here in Europe. Cheers and good luck. Oh, thank you. Hope you enjoy a restful European sleep. I don't know what that means. So, as some of you might be aware, I live in the United States of America. These colors don't run. And I live in a small, oddly shaped state called West Virginia. And I'm not sure how big this is, like, in international news. I know I saw an article about it in The Guardian. But we recently had, like, in the city where I live, Charleston, we recently had a major chemical spill. There was a storage container next to one of our rivers that was full of, I'll never be able to say the name of the chemical right, it's like methyl cyclo-4-methanol something, and a large quantity of it recently leaked into the river. It started leaking on Thursday, but we weren't really informed about the leak until Thursday evening, and as a result, I have not been able to contact or consume tap water since Friday. Friday morning was the first time I knew about it, which means, you know, there was a huge rush on bottled water, and I have not been able to take a shower or cook or wash dishes or anything. And as you might imagine, it's been a little stressful. Where the hell is it? Is it up from here? Doesn't look like it's up. Feels like it's... feels like it's right here. Well, I have plenty of bombs, so I guess I can... No, maybe not. I hate it when the black market isn't obvious. Like, I actually have to go hunting for it. I guess it's up from here. Ah, crap. But yeah, that fucking sucks. If you, ah, crap, I shouldn't have done that. Oh man, I'm in trouble. Yeah, if you want my advice, don't live somewhere where there's companies that are going to dump chemicals into the river. It's not a fun time. The fuck is it? Ah, I see it. Okay. Alright, ghost. Oh god. Phew. And I just barely have enough to buy the Ankh too. Wow. Hello, Just Drop and Enhanced Wizard. Sounds rough, that's awful. Yeah, It kind of sucks. Hopefully... Crap. I just walked right into that frog. Hopefully, the area where my office is, which is about 3 miles from my house or so, well, according to a map posted by the water company, the area of the city where my office is should already be safe, and the area where my house is right outside that area. So I'm hoping tomorrow, maybe my house should be, the water should be safe here. I don't know. Like, some sources say, like, it's already taken care of in that area, but other sources say it's not 100% safe yet, so I don't know. What the fuck character is this? This is, well, I don't know if she has a name, but I think this is... It's either one of the starting characters or one of the first characters you unlock. And, she's been, I decided to switch the character up for, you know, a little variety. And she's been my, my other go-to character for a while. I've also played the ninja a few times. I probably can't afford... I was going to buy a bomb bag, but I probably can't even afford that. I had to use quite a few bombs on the previous level, finding the black market entrance. I don't like the fact that the damsels still cry for help, even inside the kissing parlor. Like, I don't really like what that implies. Like, she's there against her will. So the shopkeeper is actually, like, a pimp. See how long I can survive. Nope, not very long. Okay. She looks smaller for some reason. Maybe it's the lack of a clown nose. Probably. So yeah, the reason I attacked the shopkeeper there was because I died, and there's no point in continuing the hell run or the hell attempt if you lose the Ankh. I could have kept going and just tried for another Olmec kill, but I want to make at least a little bit of progress towards doing a hell run during the stream. Yeah, when a monkey latches onto you, there are a few possibilities. In order of what I would like to happen, they can steal gold from you, which is no big deal, because it's like 500 gold or something like that. They can steal ropes from you, which kind of sucks, because they take 3 ropes when they do that. They can take a bomb from you, which isn't that bad, you just have to make sure you get away quickly. Or they can stun you, which is probably the worst thing that can happen to you. Especially if you are... Whew, especially if you are... making your way across a spike pit like that. So yeah, that was the... fuck. That was the worst possible outcome. But, no worries. We press on. You know, in the original Spelunky sprite for the Explorer, I didn't realize that the red thing on his face was a nose. Like, I don't know what I thought it was. I think I thought it was like... I thought it was like a bubble, like he was blowing a bubble with bubble gum or something. Which, it wouldn't make sense why, or it wouldn't make sense that that would always be there, but, I don't know, for whatever reason, I just didn't parse that. Shut up, Steam Universe. Nobody cares. I didn't get a beta Steam machine, so I don't give a fuck what you have to say next. because that was the only reason I signed up for that. Bastards. I mean, don't they realize that I'm a YouTube superstar? They've given me a Steam Machine beta. I would have gotten them so much exposure. You know, the last Spelunky video I posted of my last live stream almost broke into the triple digit views. Yeah. I'm going places. I think that's the only reason anyone signed up for Steam Universe. Yeah, I should probably just unsubscribe. Ah, crap. Yeah. Oh, man. I succumbed to deadly snake venom. Oh, well. That run was not going that great for me anyway. Aw, man. I didn't mean to do that. Sorry, dog. Been having a little more trouble with the right R2, the equivalent of the right trigger on my PS2 controller, which is what you use to run. Like, occasionally I'll find that I stopped pressing the button hard enough and I'm no longer running, which can be really unfortunate if you are if you're doing a jump that requires you to run. So I just have to make sure I keep it pressed down extra hard. So yeah, since there's no water, that meant no coffee before the stream. So I bought a really crappy energy drink instead. I found that having a quick burst of caffeine before the stream starts can help keep me focused and energetic. Because if I don't have some sort of mind-altering substance, I find it a little harder to focus and, you know, keep the incessant chatter going. So yeah, the energy drink tasted terrible, as energy drinks do, but it has caffeine in it, so that's really all that matters. Hopefully by the time the next stream happens, I should be able to get my usual cup of terrible gas station coffee. Or I could have some alcohol that helps too, but I don't know, not a huge fan. Like, it's okay. I don't seem to enjoy it as much as some people do. Should have drank a bucket of Coke. Well, if I drink a lot of Coke, that has other problems. Like, drinking a shitload of sugar would not make me feel better. You need Wawa out there. I've heard people say good things about Wawa. That's one of those grocery stores that like sells deli sandwiches and stuff too, right? Like, they have sort of a makeshift restaurant. There's a grocery store in the South called Publix. That's kind of the same way. We don't really have anything like that here. We have convenience stores called Sheetz. And more of those are popping up nearby. And they're kind of like that. Only they're not like a full grocery store. You can't buy you know, produce and stuff there. But they have more food options than your typical store. Of course, ever since the water stopped being usable, you know, nothing's open. I can go to Kroger, which, you know, thank God, because if not, then I'd be completely out of luck when it comes to liquids. But all the restaurants are closed, movie theater's been closed, pretty much everything that's not a grocery store. Or, you know, I mean, I work in an office, so I don't really deal with the public or anything, so I don't strictly need to shower. I mean, I'd like to be able to, but you can't always get what you want, I guess. Although my boss did call me on Sunday evening to let me know that we would be allowed to wear jeans during the water crisis. And I thought that was pretty nice of her. Should have eaten the ground coffee. Well, you know, I used to work in a gas station, like, 10 years ago. And I worked the midnight shift a lot. And that was before I really started drinking coffee. But I would eat the coffee beans pretty frequently, because we just had these big bags of coffee beans that we grinded in the store, or ground in the store, to make the coffee. And, you know, it was free. And I actually kind of like the taste of coffee beans. Especially, like, chocolate-covered ones. But, you know, I would just, like, pour me a little styrofoam cup full of coffee beans and just eat them, like popcorn or something. But, of course, you'd have to eat a lot of coffee beans to get the amount of caffeine you would get from a cup of coffee. Do me a solid and don't do anything amazing for the next 30 seconds. I gotta go expel urine. Well, thank you for that vivid description of the act. Anything else up here? I don't think so. It's a lot of money down there. Oh, not worth using a bomb on. If I was doing a treasure run, then maybe. My strategy for doing the daily challenges has basically been just trying to beat the game without buying anything in the shops, which has been working pretty well for me so far. Like the daily challenge where I almost cracked the top 100, I should probably use a bomb to get more ropes, since I have 7 of one and 3 of the other. Yeah, that challenge run was just a straight through shot. Just, I made it to Olmec, but I was not able to defeat him. And it's tough because you're probably not going to get any sort of any kind of mobility items or anything. Like no cape, no gloves, definitely no jetpack. I can never kill these piranhas reliably. Except for just now. But I did take a hit before I was able to kill them, so. I mean, if you're doing a run where you don't buy anything, the only chance you have of getting those items is, like, if you're lucky enough to get a sacrifice, or if you're lucky enough to find it in a crate, which are two, You know, I mean, you have to get lucky if you want that to happen. But I'm getting better about not having to rely on those items. Because, like I said, I mean, in that one run, I made it to Olmec with hardly anything. I just plain don't like the taste of any coffee. Most teas are pretty good, though. I didn't used to like coffee. But, it's sort of grown on me. I mean, it helps if you have good coffee, which, you know, we have, a couple really good coffee shops in the area, so that's where I kind of developed my taste for coffee. I saw a blip on the radar. Where was it? Over here? I know I saw a blip. Oh, there it is. It's got to be further down, I guess. Ah, crap. This guy. The vampire's another one of those enemies I have trouble reliably dealing with. Ah, if I can find Ash's grave and pick up a shotgun, that would be a great help. Oh. Oh, I see it. Okay, cool. Well, let me pick that up. Let me summon the ghosts accidentally. Well, I guess since he's coming anyway, I might as well go on ahead and pick that up. Oh crap. Played any Rogue Legacy recently, Duke? Not really. Like I said, most of my video gaming time has been devoted to this. I mean, I'm pretty much done with Rogue Legacy. Like, I beat it. I beat it on New Game Plus, so I'm on New Game Plus 2. And I don't really know how far I'm going to go with that. Because I hear there are like 6 levels of New Game Plus in that game. So, and it gets pretty ridiculous at the higher levels. Man, I am not doing too good on health. This kind of sucks. Oh, was there an Ultra Mist just dropped? That sucks. It'd be nice to, be pretty nice to get the cup. That's what I'm going to start calling it, because I don't know how to pronounce what it's actually called. It's like Tapala or something. Let's see. Maybe I can just blow this guy up. I don't know. He might be too close to the shop. But if I go down there, I'm almost certainly going to die. Maybe I can drop a rope and deal with him. I want to try a bomb. I think this is far enough away from the shop that I should be okay. Oh, okay. Well, it didn't kill him, but it put me in a better position to kill him. I just have to stay up here and not let him enter human form. Because if he enters human form, that's when he starts going crazy and jumping all over the place. But as long as he is in bat form, I should be able to deal with him. I have to lure him back up here. Oh, excellent. Tiki Trap did my job for me. The gloves and the cape is a pretty good combination. Not as good as the jetpack, but probably the next best thing, especially if you have the spring boots as well. Oh crap, another one. Oh, I have the equipment needed to deal with you now. Oh crap. I tried to shoot him, but I was clinging to the edge there. Shut up. You didn't miss it. You can sacrifice the Neanderthals on it. Oh, okay. Yeah, but like, I have no idea how many of those you actually have to sacrifice to get the cup. It's always been, I mean, I've never gotten anything from sacrificing Neanderthals to it. Well, let's see. I should be able to get the damsel up there without dying. I don't know. It's going to be a delicate operation. To require the utmost concentration on my part. Crap. Once you get good enough with the shotgun, you can negate the knockback it gives you. Once you get the muscle memory down to push the opposite direction and just enough so that you don't end up going either way. Alright, I should mine this guy for some blood. Oh, crap. It's not going to be easy since I want to stick to that tree. I got some from him. Didn't get another health yet. I really wish the cup just gave you health back for killing enemies instead of having to actually physically touch. Instead of having to actually physically touch the blood. Because what I end up doing is I end up, like, focusing too much on trying to collect the blood. And I, end up throwing myself in the spikes and stuff accidentally. I think three, but they're cumulative. So you have to sacrifice three Neanderthals? I don't know. Feels like I sacrificed a whole bunch more than that and I didn't get anything. I don't know though. Man, look at all this treasure. Would be a good room for a score run. Oh, three Neanderthals on top of a damsel. I don't know, it feels like I've done at least that much before. And do they have to be alive, or is it three dead Neanderthals? Because it's a lot tougher to get them on the altar alive than to get them on it dead. Yeah, I'll buy some more bombs. Why the heck not? 29 is a good number of sticky bombs to have. Hot, says Bippo, in response to three Neanderthals on top of a damsel. That's how I was born, says Just Drop. Oh, they have to be alive. Yeah, that's probably why it didn't work out for me then. Oh god. There's a lot of Sasquatches down here. Alright, three health. Excellent. Alright, this is probably where the Moai statue is, so don't let me miss it. You know, I hope it wasn't on the first level because I didn't really check the level that thoroughly. Oh crap, that guy? Really? But I don't want that guy to be on this level. Man, this is a weird layout for the ice caves. I don't think I've ever seen a layout quite this convoluted before. Man, I really hope I didn't miss the mo I had on the first ice cave level. I wasn't even thinking about it, to be honest. Because it doesn't look like it's on this level. Sometimes when you kill the woolly mammoth, they drop freeze race. Kind of like how when you kill the giant frogs in the jungle, they sometimes drop spring boots. Not always, but sometimes. Alright, I have done my due diligence in this level, and I don't think the Moai head is here. Crap. Oh, there it is. Good. Excellent. Alright. I like the Moai head level because you can, you kind of have free reign to dick around a little bit. Like, you can look around and collect as much treasure as you want and take all the stupid risks you want because if you die, you just want to come back anyway, so you might as well go crazy. Oh, crap. I wasn't really paying attention to where I was walking. Well, I lost my shotgun, which that sucks. There's no way to bring carryable items into the Moai head with you unless you do some crazy shit. All right, last ice caves level, and we no longer have the security of the Ankh. I'm gonna mine this guy for some health while I'm here. Crap, I think I went too far down. That was a free 3 bombs I just got, because I did a nice skillful jump off that UFO. Normally I would have had to use a rope to get up there. I like the way the old game did the score tally for a level, where enemies killed and treasure collected appeared in rows. Yeah, that was kind of cool. I think, doesn't Rogue Legacy basically do that as well? Well, it does that with the enemies, but not with the treasure, because that would just be like a bunch of coins. Crap. Well, I guess I can grab that. Mummies, really great for if you're doing a score run, because they always drop two of those rubies. Rubies being the most valuable treasure item in the game. I wish I had spike boots. Makes dealing with those flying insect things a lot easier. But I don't know what the fuck that is. Some kind of scorpion dragonfly thing? Whatever it is, I don't like it. Alright. Ah, crap, 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 crap. Okay. And luckily, I was stunned. Otherwise, that tiki trap would have killed me. Alright. Let's go this way. Let's jump into our own bomb like an idiot. Aw, man. I was really hoping I could sick that trap on the scorpion dragonfly thing. Alright, I am taking way too much time here. I have to find Anubis, quick. And kill him and steal his... Oh, there he is. Alright, so one thing that I've learned about that scepter is you should really never use it. It shoots those really powerful purple beams at enemies, and it's really cool when it works because it seeks out the enemies and just wrecks them. But you also have a really good chance of killing yourself with it. Like, if it kills one enemy, then it'll automatically seek out the next one. And, it doesn't discriminate. Like, it won't come after you, but if the next enemy it seeks out is behind you, like, if it's on the other side of you, then it will, pass through you and deal 10 points of damage to you on the way to the next enemy. Alright. I feel pretty good about my odds of me... Oh. That's what I get for my hubris, I guess. It's fun when you get a great run and the enemy tally ends up going way off screen. Yeah. Yeah, that's really satisfying. Yeah, never say anything good about about how your Spelunky run is going. Because Spelunky will conspire against you to prove you wrong. Oh well. I'm sorry, but that was funny. Oh, you don't have to apologize. I agree with you. That's why I laughed. If you can't laugh at yourself when you play Spelunky, then you're not going to have a good time. Crap. I'm trying to pick up this pot without... Well, I guess I can just let him run off the edge there. He'll probably be safe. Yeah, see? No spikes down there. That was a close one. I almost triggered that trap. Compass is clutch pickup for the first box, yeah. Wait, how does having the compass help with Olmec? Because, I mean, the door in Olmec is always in the same place, right? Well, I guess you mean the door to hell, not just the normal door. But I don't know, I don't think the compass will point to the hell door. Ah, crap. Does it? That's probably not going to kill it. Fuck. Wasted two bombs trying to kill that damn spider. You know what? I want my sticky bombs. By any means necessary. Yeah, come in here. That's right. If I waste two bombs on you, then I'll be damned if I'm not going to get something out of it. Oh, the compass does point to the hell door? That's weird. Yeah. So Awesome Games Done Quick is over. They raised over $1 million for their charity, which is pretty fucking awesome. The only games I caught this year were Yoshi's Island and Super Mario World. We would watch more of it, but I looked at the schedule. Most of the games I was interested in were only happening when I was at work or way too late for me to stay up and watch. Which kind of sucks. I assume that they're all archived, though, so I might go back and watch a few of those. If any of you watched AGDQ and have recommendations for good speedruns to watch, let me know. The position of that scorpion. Alright, stay there. Good scorpion. Yep, keep looking that way. Aw, man. I'm gonna have to go up and around. Crap, that means I'm gonna have to use a rope. Well, I don't know, I might be able to go under this guy without pissing him off. Just wanna use a lot of the Maddox durability, but the chest is down there anyway, so I guess I might as well come this way. I'm gonna have to use a bomb to get up, though. Maybe a rope, too. That sucks. Actually, it looks like I can just keep going. Oh, yeah. Not a really big fan of speedruns, so AGDQ never interested me too much. Yeah, I don't know. I like watching people attempt live speedruns, especially if they're, like, racing. That's really interesting to me. Like, tool-assisted speedruns, I don't really get the appeal of those. Since, it takes skill, obviously, to know all the glitches and exploits and all that to make a good tool-assisted speedrun. But it's not like a spectator event the way a live speedrun is. But if it's a game I'm interested in, then watching someone break it in really amazing ways can be a lot of fun to watch. Especially if there's, like, people explaining what's going on and stuff. I prefer AGDQ to the people that task. Yeah, exactly. Like, tool-assisted speedruns, they're interesting in theory, I guess. Worth using a bomb here, I guess. Parachute. That's okay. Like, I've never actually watched a live Spelunky speedrun, but I bet that would be pretty awesome to watch. They always kind of make me feel like a terrible gamer. Well, yeah, I mean, that's how I felt watching that solo eggplant run in Spelunky. But, you know, it inspired me to start playing the game more and get better at it. And I think I have gotten better at it, you know, today's poor performances aside. Like, I still make dumb newbie mistakes, but I don't make nearly as many as I used to. Like, letting letting that block crush me when I was mining with the Matic. Like, textbook dumb newbie mistake. But, you know, I'm talking at the same time, so I feel at least a little bit entitled to make a few of those. The Game Boy Zelda speedrun blew my mind. I think it took 1 minute 22 seconds. I saw a speedrun. I don't even know if it was a speedrun. It was just just someone glitching the game in really hilarious ways. I don't think it ended in them actually beating the game, though. It just kind of corrupted everything and played with the game's fucked up physics and stuff. Ah, crap. Oh, man. Doing this without light is not a good idea. Yeah. If I hadn't dropped my torch, I might have been able to pull that off. Alright. Let's do a few more. I'd like to at least get to the City of Gold. I thought I was going to get to the City of Gold on a couple runs ago, but didn't work out. But yeah, that's the next milestone for my Spelunky live streaming career. So I'm not sure what to do about my Steam game backlog. Yeah, I'm with you. I have so many games in my backlog that I haven't even touched. It's embarrassing. Now, granted, most of them are games that I paid $5 or less for because of Steam sales or Humble Bundles. But still, I gained roughly 300 plus Steam games in 2013. Whoa! Holy shit. That's, that's quite a bit more. I think I have like 180 some Steam games total. Five hundred eighty games. Jesus Christ. I thought I had it tough. Yeah, that's a pretty intimidating backlog. Yeah, good luck with that. I have a fraction of the games you have, and I don't even know how to deal with mine. Lots of bundles and sales, yeah. But still, even with bundles and sales, 300 games, that seems like quite a bit of cash must have been spent on that since you bought them all in 1 year. But hey, look on the plus side. Think of how much money you can make by selling the cards from those games. Probably like 30 or 40 bucks, maybe. I don't know. Okay, so it's like 10 cents per card, more or less. That's the average, and 5 cards per game. So let's say 50 cents per game times 300 games. That's like 150 bucks. No way, my math must be off. Maybe I'm being generous with the 10 cents per card estimate. But if that's the case, then, you know, I don't know how much you spent on the games, and, you know, it would be rude to ask, but if you can make back $150 of your investment, that's not bad. Of course, not all of the games have cards, probably. I don't know how many Steam games have cards at this point. I know a lot more of them have them than they had when they introduced the cards. I sold a hat in Dota 2 for 15 bucks. That's all I play Dota 2 for now. Wow. I think the item I sold for the most money is I sold a weapon in Team Fortress 2. For like $5. which I thought was pretty impressive because I haven't even played Team Fortress 2 that much. Like, I have maybe 5 hours total in the game. So I imagine the people on my Steam friends list who have like 500 hours in that game probably make a not insignificant amount of money just by selling Team Fortress 2 items. I'm never going to be able to get this arrow to... There we go. I doubled my holiday sale funds by selling off cards from all my games. I had like 30-ish bucks to start with, spent most of the sale idling on 75-ish games for their cards and sold them. Wow. See, it's actually... It's against my economic interests to play nothing... Fuck. To play nothing but Spelunky. Because, you know, the 100 or so hours I've spent playing this game... I could have just been idling every game I have in my Steam account that has cards, and I don't know, I probably could have made like 50 bucks or so, I don't know. Of course, the only thing I can do with that money is buy more games I'm not going to play. Well, I could probably like work out something and like offer to buy people games at a discount, and they PayPal me the money. And I buy the games with funds in the Steam wallet. I know that there are definitely a lot of people doing that. I don't know. Just doesn't really seem worth the time. I mean... Idling in other games is not going to increase my APMs in Spelunky. APMs being, you know, how all professional Spelunky players measure their Spelunky ability. Like my I just jumped twice there. That's an action. Throwing a rope, that's an action. Like my APMs are just crazy. Like, I have so many of them, I can't even calculate them. That's how many actions I'm able to perform. I used to play a lot of TF2. I eventually sold everything marketable for some decent moolah. Yeah. I mean... If I were a kid or a teenager, and, you know, I, see? I can never fucking kill the prawns without taking a hit. Never. I should have just jumped over. I don't know why I didn't do that. It looked like I wouldn't be able to make this jump because I hit the ceiling, but I totally did. But yeah, if I didn't have a job, like if I was still living at home, I'd probably do nothing but play Team Fortress 2. Because it's free. Well, it's a free game now. It's pretty fun. And you can actually... I mean, fuck. When I was like 12, I had a newspaper route. It was just something that I did after school. And I made like $100 a month from that. And I bet, like, if a kid plays like 5 hours of Team Fortress 2 a night or something, which, you know, isn't crazy for a kid, they could probably make more than I was making at my paper route. Which is weird to think about. The future is fucking weird, guys. Kids are getting jobs as video game engineers instead of getting a paper route like I did. Or video game medics. The medic's the only class I'm good at playing in Team Fortress 2. Because you don't really have to think that much. I was hoping to get a little bit more money before I head into the black market. But it's not a whole lot of money to be had here. I suck at competitive Dota 2, so I just play easy bots for stuff. Actually, I'm probably decent, I just get terrible teams. I tried Dota 2, but I'm so not even close to good at those kinds of games. Yeah, I'm not really good at any competitive multiplayer game. Especially not, like, real-time strategy games. Well, fuck. What am I gonna do? I don't have enough for the Ankh. I'm not going to find 13,000 gold on this level. I'm probably going to have to do something really dumb, like attack a shopkeeper. Or I could just die by this Tiki guy. That's fun too. Alright, I have never successfully killed a shopkeeper in the black market. I've successfully killed shopkeepers a couple times, but it's pretty rare. Alright, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to throw my boomerang at this guy, immediately run back and collect all these bombs, and then hopefully the boomerang will stun this guy long enough for me to scramble up to the left side there. Probably could have grabbed that shotgun too. Nope. God, they just move so fucking fast. According to Steam, I clocked 1,333 hours in Team Fortress 2. Wow. It's my most played game, Borderlands 2 coming in second at 668. I have a lot of time on my hands, see. Well, you know, I'm a big fan of the saying, time you enjoy wasting is not wasted time. I don't know who said that. I think it was like Voltaire or Oscar Wilde or someone like that. Most interesting quotes are either Voltaire or Oscar Wilde, or possibly Mark Twain. In fact, I'm pretty sure all good quotes can be traced back to one of those three people. So, you know, if you were entertained for those 2,000 plus hours and you know, more power. If I had that much time to sink into video games, I probably would. I mean, I do have that much time. I just, well, I don't know. I was going to say I spread it out more, but even my most played games, like, you could add up like my top 10 most played games and they probably wouldn't reach the amount of time you've put into TF2. I mean, not that, you know, not that my position is better than yours or anything, since, you know, I don't know. You know, I don't know what your situation is, but, yeah, I don't regret any of my gaming so far. Well, good. Me either. My top play game is Binding of Isaac, which I think has like 220 some hours in it. And then I think my second is Fallout 3, which has 100 some hours. And then my third, I'm pretty sure, is this now. And most of that time, kind of embarrassingly, has been just in the past, like, 3 or 4 weeks. But, you know, no regrets. I mean, shit, go back and look at some of my original Spelunky streams and see how far I made it in an average stream and compare that to now. And, like, I've gotten a lot better. I mean, shit, there was a point where I thought I would never actually be able to beat the game, but, proved myself wrong there. Of course, now, I think I don't think I'll ever be able to beat Hell. And, I don't know if I'll be able to prove myself wrong on that one or not. If I could just make it to Hell one time, then I would feel a lot better about my chances. So far, I've yet to actually make it to Hell. The farthest I've gotten is, I made it to Olmec with the Book of the Dead once. And, if I could have beaten him, then I would have finally unlocked Hell. Assuming I had enough bomb left over after I beat him to bomb my way to the entrance to Hell. I kind of like the pitching gloves. It's or glove, because you can do stuff like that. You do have to get used to the new throwing physics, but once you adjust to it, it's a pretty good way to take out some enemies. It's also a good way to safely break pots open. It's a lot easier to plan the trajectory of a throw when you know you're just going to throw it straight ahead until it hits a wall or an obstacle. Because, I mean, there's no gravity or anything. It just keeps going until it hits something. So it's a lot easier to plan where you throw something. Especially if you have a sticky bomb. Which I do not yet. That's probably safe to get that idol since the shop's right above it. I hate it when the traps are off the screen like that. Cause I mean, yeah, I should be going slower, and I should theoretically see the trap before it comes onto the screen, but you know, it sucks just walking everywhere, man. Once you get used to the running speed, the walking speed just doesn't cut it. I'm gonna have to bounce off the spider so I can dislodge the idol. There we go. Let's see. I didn't grab onto that ladder like I thought I would. I shouldn't have tried to make that jump. See, I knew before I tried the jump that it probably wasn't going to work. But I didn't listen. I did not listen to my, to that inner voice. I wish running was as desirable in real life. Yeah. I wish I was able to run in real life. That'd be nice. I don't know how people run. Like, I mean, don't they get, like, really tired? I know I do. I don't understand how it works. I wish they would explain it to me. I was going to say I'd have to use a bomb to get her, but I don't know why I thought that. I hate running, yet I have to. Like, I mean, I guess if you run a lot, then you can build up your ability to run. But, like, I don't know how you even get to that point. Because I can run for, like, 10 seconds before I'm hilariously, pathetically out of breath. So, do I just run for 10 seconds for, like, a week? Until eventually I can run for 20 seconds. And then a week later I run for 30 seconds. Like that. I mean, at that rate, I'll never be able to actually run a decent distance. Wow, 2 rubies. That's pretty good. I don't know. I wish leveling up your real life abilities was as clear as leveling up RPG abilities. Because, like, in an Elder Scrolls game, you know, it tells you. You know, you run a lot, and it eventually it says athletics has gone up. And, like, you know exactly where you are. See, that's what I want those Fitbit things. There's, like, the Fitbit and the Nike Fuel Band. And I think Jawbone makes one. See, that's what I want those things to be. I want them to be, like, little wrist computers that say, you know, you program them in. How you want to plan out your leveling up your running ability, and then, you know, they have a little display, and they say you need to run for this amount of time, this many times per week, and by this date, your running ability will have increased such and such percent. And so far, the technology is not yet there, but. You know, I'm pretty confident that we'll get there. Like, I looked into them because one of my friends has sweared by his... I think he has a Fitbit. And he swore by it. Its ability to motivate him to, you know, keep in shape and exercise and stuff. And, like, I looked it up, and it's pretty much just a pedometer. It's just like a glorified pedometer that can connect to his phone, and I don't see what value he gets out of that. Cause I mean I have a pedometer. I have one in my 3DS, and if I walk 1,000 steps a day, which is not that much, then I get 10 play coins, and that's not really a whole lot of motivation. And I mean, with the Fitbit, you don't even get play coins out of it, so I don't really know what the point of it is. I don't know. I mean, I guess it helps that he has a sense of, like, crap. He has a sense of, like, personal motivation, which, you know, I definitely don't have. I was hoping I wouldn't have to use another rotate up there, but I guess I did. But yeah, as soon as they invent complicated wrist exercise computers, then by golly, I'm finally going to get in shape. In an Elder Scrolls game, you can put on boots that make you blind and have you run faster than a jet. Yeah, I mean... I don't know about the being blind part, but I would definitely feel better about running if I could equip an item to increase my exercise ability. That'd be pretty nice. I mean, come on, it's 2014 and we don't have this stuff yet? What kind of shitty future am I living in? Jesus. Basically, I'm an unmotivated baby with no willpower or self-control, who is unable to do anything productive unless it's a game. That's what I'm saying. But, you know, I don't think I'm alone there. There's nothing worth waking that spider up for. Get that one thing. I think the chat's like a minute behind, so it's probably somebody on the previous level that I missed. Oh. Virtuix Omni. Never heard of it. Is that another one of those wrist exercise monitors? Basically a treadmill for a controller. Oh. So it's like a game that you control with the treadmill? That's kind of interesting. I have like an exercise bike, and I used to use it like last year. There was a good long stretch there where I used it every day for a few months, and I felt like it was doing me a lot of good, but it was so fucking boring, and I eventually just stopped doing it. I should start doing it again. But yeah, if it was a game, and like I could pedal faster in certain parts to get more points or something, I don't know. I mean, it seems like that would still be kind of a boring game. What the fuck? I thought that one was triggered because there was a rock down there. But I guess that rock was already there. There are videos on YouTube demonstrating Team Fortress play with the Omni and an Oculus Rift. So wait, you have to actually walk on the treadmill to control your character? Man, that seems like, it does not seem like that would work that well. Because, I mean, in a first-person shooter, your character runs, like, faster than any human can move. Like, I think I read somewhere that in Doom, your character's running at like 80 miles an hour or something like that. And I'm sure modern first-person shooters aren't that fast, but the characters are probably still running a good 20 miles per hour or so. So, that would not be easy to do on a treadmill. Although, I mean, that is like the virtual reality that that we were all promised when we were kids. Come to fruition. What the f? Because not only do you have the Oculus Rift, but like your movement is actually like represented by the game. Of course, it's only like straightforward movement on the treadmill, but still. I mean, I'm assuming you still have to control, you have to hold a controller in order to change the direction of your run and stuff, which would take you out of the experience a little bit. Probably feels cool to play it, but you do look like a jackass in the thing. Yeah, I would never do something like that where other people could see. I would try it though. At least see what it's like. Assuming, you know, I was not around any other people at the time. I have no idea how the Omni works, but it doesn't seem too tough to control. That's neat. It's probably like $5,000 or something though. So, not exactly consumer technology, I'm assuming. I should mine that caveman for some health. Assuming, oh fuck. assuming the ghost doesn't come, which of course it did. Oh god. Alright, I might be able to... Oh, never mind. I need to just get out of here. I can post a link to the video if you want to watch it at some point. Yeah, I'd like to check it out. See, the problem with the graveyard levels is that nothing has blood. It's all just bones and skeletons and bloodless zombies. Wish I didn't have to use an item to get out of there. But yeah, I would never buy an Oculus Rift, but I would definitely try it if I had the chance. There we go. I can get a little bit of blood from this pug. Sorry, pug, but you know, it's either you or me. And I don't want it to have to be me. Apparently there's a secret level that you can get by bombing underneath this guy with a crown. But I don't know. I tried bombing under him on a previous playthrough and I couldn't find anything. So I'm not sure if that person was messing with me or if there's actually something there or what. The Omni actually seems to be omnidirectional. Really? Huh. I'd have to actually see the thing to figure out how that works. Alright, I didn't see any blinky. I didn't really explore the whole level. Guess I have to look around a little bit more. What level is this? 2-2? Well, hopefully it is on the next one. Thank you. Thank you. Alright, let's set my shotgun down so it's an easy grabbing reach. Go ahead and pick this thing up and get the heck on out of here. I've been to that level. It's pretty cool. I'm gonna have to do some more exploring. Oh, by the way, in the last stream, I said that it's impossible to both go to the worm level and go to the black market. And of course I was forgetting that there's also an entrance to the worm level in Ice Caves 1. So it's possible to go to the black market in the jungle and then in the ice caves go to the worm level. Of course you have to the only way you can do that. Oh, wow. And buy the jetpack and still have enough for the Ankh. Sweet. You have to hope that the Moai head is in 3-4. Because if it's not, then, you know, you can't get the item that you need to eventually go to hell. And in my experience, the Moai head is usually in 3-2 or 3-3. Like, it's pretty rare that it's been in 3-4. So yeah, if you're trying a hell run, I probably wouldn't risk going to the worm level at all. Oh, there we go. Wow, this is a really good run so far. Oh, shit. I mean, this run's okay. I'm not getting cocky. It's like a block just under where you'd think the entrance is, if that makes any sense. Okay, I have a jetpack and a shotgun and 9 health. But I'm not getting cocky. Oh no. Because I realize the tiniest misstep could make it all for naught. Ah, crap. I'm gonna have to go this way to get to the Ankh. I can't go that way because that boomerang guy is gonna kill me as soon as I jump. Fuck's sake. Oh well. At least the top set of spikes is distracted by that dead caveman. Alright. I still have enough to buy a bomb box too. Sweet. No, stop jinxing me, Pippo. What the hell are you doing? I'm guaranteed to lose now. I mean, I'm probably guaranteed to lose either way, but like I said, I'd like to at least make it to the City of Gold during a live run. I just don't want to deal with that. If I can make it to hell, that would be really cool. But, you know, I'm not, City of Gold is the first milestone I want to do during a stream. Three Yetis with one shot. Is the plural of Yeti, Yetis? It seems like it might be one of those words that's its own plural. Like one Yeti, several Yeti. I don't know what the etymology of the word Yeti is. If it's Latin, then Yeti is probably already plural. One Yetis, several Yeti. Alright, no Moai head on this level, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, like I said, it's usually 3-2 or 3-3. Oh god. See, those platforms that fall, if you ever played a video game, you would think they only fall if you land on the platform. But in Spelunky, all you have to do is touch a platform to make it fall. Well, it didn't happen then, but see, I touched the bottom of the platform with my head, and it ended up falling, which isn't very intuitive. I've died quite a few times that way. Yeti Sin, of course. One Yeti, mini Yeti Sin. Gotta be careful not to piss Kali off. Be pretty easy. Man, jetpack and a shotgun is just the best thing ever. I know I shouldn't get used to it because I'm not going to have the shotgun for much longer, but still, it's nice while it lasts. Alright, I don't see the Moai head on this level either. And I'm pretty sure I've been all over the place. So onward, I guess. Oh crap, where the hell am I going? That was almost a disaster. Not gonna bother with that damsel since I have 10 health. And I'm about to lose all but 4 of it anyway. Alright, come on, Moai head. Yep, there it is. Excellent. Alright. See, it's actually worth it to save the damsel now, because when I leave this level, I'll end up with 5 health instead of 4. Because it doesn't matter what door you put the damsel in. I can put it in that door, and even though I'll be going through the other door, the damsel will still count. Alright, let's harvest this level for everything that's not nailed down. The Yeti seem to have so much fun on those bouncing machines. I probably would too. When I was a kid, I seem to remember really, really wanting a trampoline. I think it was that episode of the Simpsons where they got the trampoline that made me want one. Because, you know, I remember the part where all the Simpsons were bouncing on it and having fun. But, you know, the part where all the neighborhood kids were getting injured on the trampoline didn't seem to register with me. Alright, that's pretty much everything, unless I want to start bombing for gems, and I think I'm good, so. Geronimo! Buy shotgun. Death caves always remind me so much of the graveyard of the giants in La Milana. Makes me want to listen to the track for that area. Yeah, that's a good piece of music. I wish I was better at La Milana. That's a really cool game. See, when it comes to difficult games, I'm really good at games like Spelunky and I Want to Be the Guy. Well, I'm not really good at them, but I can get good at those games because it's just practice. It's just muscle memory. You know, eventually, play enough Spelunky or play enough I Want to Be the Guy, and eventually you'll get good enough at it. But oops. What time is it? 8:38. One more. And then I'll do the daily challenge. But yeah, obviously I'm still not good at Spelunky. But I think I'm still better than the average person. God, that was such a good run too. I had the jetpack. Man. See, the tiniest miscalculation. That one doesn't count. The tiniest miscalculation in trying to kill one of the Yetis just completely ends your game. The tiniest miscalculation. Like, I was a hair away from landing on the Yeti's head and killing him. But instead, the Yeti threw me into the abyss. It's those fractions, man. It's the fractions that kill you. Jetpack climbing gloves are the ultimate combo. Yeah, I agree. That run doesn't count either. I take damage on the first level, the run doesn't count. Well, if I take damage in a stupid way. Which really, it's all stupid in the mines. Unless I just get totally boned and have a shopkeeper get mad at me for something that's not my fault. Aw, man. Crap, I'm gonna have to use a bomb or a rope to get out of here. Well, at least there's another crate over there. Now the game's probably gonna punish you for screwing it up. Yeah, probably. The game does like to punish people. It's a crate and a dog. That's worth using a bomb for. And a chest. That was a very lucrative bomb. Parachute, not the most useful thing you can get from a crate, but I'll take it. Aw, man. Screw it. It's not worth using another rope on. Since I'm at full health. I do like the boomerang a lot. It's just not as useful as I'd like it to be. Like, I don't know. I always end up screwing myself with the boomerang because I think it's more powerful than it is. If you know what I mean. Like, I think, hey, I have a boomerang. I can take this guy out and throw him at, like, the Yeti or something. But, it's not good enough for those sorts of applications. Springy boots. I like springy boots. They're like the throwing gloves. They do take a little bit of adjustment, but once you adjust to them, they are very useful. They saved me many ropes in the past. Springy gloves, cape, or springy boots, cape, climbing gloves are another pretty good combo. Again, not as good as the jetpack, but it's still pretty good. This is a mediocre item run. Yeah, so far. There's not been a lot of good stuff in the crates. Should have paid more attention to that shopkeeper. Because I only have 2 bombs. And if you're doing... Fuck. If you're doing a run where you go to the black market... Then you want a good number of bombs by the time you get to the jungle. Because, I mean, sometimes you can open the black market entrance with 1 bomb. Sometimes it takes you, like, I think the most bombs I ever used is, like, 4 trying to get, because the black market entrance was in a really stupid place. I probably should have tried to kill that spider without using a bomb, but, I didn't really want to. So yeah, in these kinds of situations, spending like 2,500 on a bomb bag is definitely worth it. You know, ideally, you find some bombs in a crate or something, but the world is not always ideal. Ooh, neat. He killed himself. Well, we get those gems and that gold. Springy gloves sounds like a horrible item. Yeah, they probably would be. Make you bounce off a wall anytime you touched it. Wow, that would be horrible. Oh god. Fuck. Well, saved me a hit, but wasted my parachute. I guess that's what parachutes are for. Oh, fuck. I was too fixated on the altar. I was like, hey, an altar. I wonder if I can go back up and grab the damsel and sacrifice it. Totally missed the giant spider hanging above my head. Oh, fuck. I'm not going to be able to get the key. I was banking on getting more bombs at some point. But, doesn't look like that's going to happen. Fuck. And there's no other way into the room with the key, is there? Sure does not look like it. Well, theoretically, yeah, there's no other way in there. Theoretically, it's possible to find the black market without needing the eye. So I guess I'll play through the jungle and see if I get lucky. Of course, I'm going to have to get lucky and find more bombs as well. Find or buy more bombs. Oh, great. The fucking chest is in the ground, too. I like to think that the worse off you start in a game like this, the better your chances of winning are. Maybe it's just superstition. Well, I mean, I can see where there's something to that theory. Because if you get really good items at the beginning of a game, then you tend to get cocky. Like, if I happen to find the jetpack in the first level, then yeah, I usually end up losing because I feel like the jetpack, you know, makes me invincible, and that is definitely not the case. Let me know if you see what looks like an exit peeking out from behind rocks somewhere. I doubt I'm going to be that lucky, but you never know. Of course, I still don't have bombs at this point, so even if I do see it, it's moot at this point. Oh well, if I don't get the black market, I guess I'll just try to turn this into an Olmec run. Get another win under my belt. Because, you know, more practice is always beneficial. Fuck off. If worse comes to worse, go to one of the secret boss fights. I don't know about any secret boss fights. What secret boss fights are there? The only boss fights I know about are Olmec and King Yama. This pickaxe would actually be extremely useful if I am lucky enough to spot the black market. Secret boss fights. Yeah, I don't, I'm not familiar with any of those. Oh, you know what? Boom! Yes! This run is not wasted after all. And I'll hang on to this pickaxe, too. I should probably go up and grab that idol, since it's so close. Oh, I know I can make this jump. Yeah, there we go. Oh god. Oh, okay. I thought he picked up the boomerang again. I was about to scream. Pickaxe or boomerang? Yeah, I'll take the pickaxe with me, I guess. I should actually farm these guys for some blood while I'm here. Alright, let's go. If you get bombs in an undead level, you can always try for the secret level. Yeah, that's true. Is that secret level, is it in all the undead levels? Or is it only certain ones? Fucking sloppy. Fucking sloppy, Duke. On the plus side, if I can get some gold, I should be able to buy the Ankh and the jetpack. Just have to be careful that this frog doesn't brand me a terrorist for the rest of my life. Alright, 27,000. I think the jetpack is 29,000 in the black market. I don't know, let me double check. Oh, 30,000, okay. So 3,000 more gold. That should be good. Shouldn't be too hard to find. Boomerang. Crap. Not wasting money gambling for a boomerang. There's one right there. If I wanted to face the wrath of Tiki Man. Crap, I'm gonna have to go down and find some gold and come back up. Well, at least I have a good number of ropes. Fuck. If I got that ruby, I would have enough to buy the jetpack, but me and piranhas do not have a good history. Alright. Oh, fuck. Alright, I spent too much time on this level. Gonna grab the jetpack and get the F out of here. Do not blow up that frog. Whatever you do. Alright, monkeys. Oh, fuck. Phew. We'll need rope with the jetpack. Yeah, that's true. So I don't feel bad about wasting that one. Alright. Don't get cocky. Cockiness leads to failure. That is lesson number one in Spelunky. Lesson number two is don't jump in spikes. You think that would be lesson number one. You think that would be pretty important, but in actuality, not getting cocky is more important. Because, you know, you really shouldn't have to be told not to jump into spikes. Alright. Sorry, pup. Your blood is more valuable than the alternative. And getting the Kapala really turns you into an evil bastard in this game. It's really makes you think. Oh, fuck you, bat. God damn it. I thought I was so good at avoiding the bat. And it turns out I was not good at all. Alright, if this run goes much longer, I might skip the daily challenge for this stream since it's already going pretty long. Oh, there goes my pickaxe. Oh no, it's still there. It's not really that useful to me at this point though, well, it might be useful for navigating the temple. Oh fuck! Oh yeah. Wow, I forgot that thing was going to fall. I could go to the worm level, but I don't feel that good about my odds of surviving the worm level. That thing's still... Yeah, it's still going to fire lasers at me. Alright, I think I'm just going to head out. Of course, I won't be able to hold on to the pickaxe to the temple, because I'm going to lose it when I sacrifice myself. I kind of forgot about that part. Oh, well. Why I'm going for money at this point. I doubt I'm going to find another shop that has useful stuff. The shops really start drying up around the ice caves. It's kind of unfortunate. Oh fuck. The Moihead wasn't in that level, was it? I wasn't even paying attention. Usually you don't have to go looking for it since it's pretty big. Oh, yeah, there it is. Okay, good. Alright, let's do whatever I can on this level and save the dog. Start with 5 health when I enter the Moihead. You know, assuming I don't get frozen. Oh well. Worked out. Alright. No longer have the Ankh, so I have to be careful. I shouldn't have to tell myself that, but sometimes you do. Spike Shoes is actually a pretty good item to find at this point. It'll make it a lot easier to take out most of the enemies in the temple. I'm sorry, I don't want to kill you, but my goddess demands it. Could go to the mothership, no, that's okay. Alright, I'm not gonna press my luck here. Oh, there's Anubis. Look at that. Alright. Note to self. Do not use Scepter. Even if it would be really useful for me to say, kill that alligator man. Well, actually, that would be an even dumber idea, because the way those guys teleport around, I would be almost guaranteed to kill myself then. Alright, be on the lookout for thwomps. Like that one. Okay, that's been triggered. This place has pretty good music. You know, I never made it to the temple level in the original Spelunky. in Spelunky Classic. The ice skate is the farthest I ever made it. So I never heard this music until I installed the classic music pack. Oh, wow, look at that. City goal is right there. As long as I don't do something extremely stupid, I should be okay. Bong. Well, since the pup's here, I could, I'll just rescue him. And I should be able to grab this as well. There are two kinds of idol traps in the temple. There's that one, where it's just like the one in, well, it's not just like the jungle one, because the platform disappears immediately instead of gradually disappearing. And then there's another one where the walls close in on you, and like a spike ceiling comes down and crushes you. That one's a lot worse. All right, well, this is a first for Duke of the Spelunk. I finally made it to the City of Gold during a stream. And if you're doing a treasure run, the City of Gold is it's a pretty good strategy because, you know, everything you bomb or every piece of terrain gives you gold when you destroy it. Fuck. So, what the fuck? I jumped on that guy. How did it hit me? Oh well, I'm not gonna stress about it. Oh crap, that was my last bomb. Wow. I'm used to having way more bombs than I have at this point, so I can sort of bomb enemies with impunity. But that's... So there we go. That was the City of Gold. I hope it was exciting. Didn't even find the damn Book of the Dead. Okay, daily challenge. Well, thanks for your enthusiasm anyway, Dimwait. Alright, let's change it up a little bit for the challenge. I'd be Hard Hat Lady. She's a strong character choice because she's the only one who's ever done the solo banana run, or the solo eggplant run. Why the hell did I say banana? I think this is still my favorite music in the game, the Mines level. It starts out really strong. The game does. As far as the soundtrack goes. The rest of the soundtrack is good, but the Mines is my favorite. I think that's why I don't like the new soundtrack that much, because the Mines definitely has the worst music out of all the levels. And you know, the Mines, at least when, well, the Mines is the music you hear the most often, because, especially when you're bad at the game. Alright, well, not much treasure so far, but, haven't taken damage yet. Knock on wood, etc. Anti-jinx. Good run, though. Thank you. Way farther than I have ever been. Play Padlock number 5, yeah. That's a good character. And it's weird that there are still 5 more characters I have to unlock, because the Steam achievement says unlock all 8 characters. And I'm sure I've unlocked more than 3 characters at this point. I've unlocked, like, God, at least 5 or 6. And if there are still 5 characters that I have to unlock, then that means there are more than 8 unlockable characters. I really want that pile of gold, but... Fuck! I knew it. I should have just left it alone. So yeah, I don't know how many unlockable characters there actually are. I think the Steam achievement says unlock all 8 characters. I don't know. Maybe it said 18. And I was just very high at the time. And by high, I of course mean high on life, which is the only thing I get high on. Love it when you throw something at a pot and it just erupts into a spray of blood. It's pretty satisfying to know that that you neutralize that threat in a very effective way. This is a punishing daily. Yeah, it's been pretty rough so far. Pretty sparse on the treasure, too. Now see, normally, I would never even consider picking up an idol in the mines, but if I'm going for treasure, sometimes it's worth it. Like, if I go further down and I see that there aren't any shops, I might actually go back for it. I don't know. It's only 5,000. It's not really worth it in the grand scheme of things. So yeah, like I was saying before, my strategy for the daily challenge is to just... Crap. Is to just try to beat the game without spending any money. And that's not going to get me into the top 100 or, you know, make me competitive or anything. If you want to be competitive in the daily challenge, then you have to either ghost mine or make it to the City of Gold. Or both, I guess. Would like to explore further over to the right, but I don't know if it's worth wasting a rope. I don't think it is. The achievement says to rescue all 8 hidden characters. Yeah, and I've unlocked like at least 5 or 6, like I said, and there's still 5 that I have to unlock, so I don't know what the deal is. Man, I really, really hate it when there are monkeys on the vines and I can't taunt them and make them jump into the spikes. Anything worth going up for? Can't really tell. Oh god. Fuck. I forgot that tree was going to blow up. This challenge is not going that well. Things do not look good for Homestar Runner. That was a good trade. 1 bomb for 3. Can't get that emerald, unfortunately. Well, let's see, I could use a rope and go up and get that idol, which I think I will. See what else is up here, too. It doesn't look like much. Well, there's a damsel, and it would probably be a pretty good idea since I'm running extremely low on health. I usually don't use ropes or bombs to get damsels, unless I'm either really low on health or I have a chance to sacrifice them. Crap, don't go this way. See, I need to kill this plant without hitting the idol with my whip. Because hitting it with your whip triggers the trap, and I don't have any way to get out of there at the moment. Well, except ropes, but that piranha would probably kill me first. Alright. There's nothing over here, right? No, I've already been over here. Okay. Hey, what's up, Afferal? I hear ya. I'm just looking at the chat. Chill out, Ghosty. That's a pretty fruitful run, as far as money goes. Or a pretty fruitful level, I should say. Let's see. The giant frogs actually aren't that hard to kill with your whip. So I might be able to do this without wasting a bomb. Well, that didn't work. Springy boots. Oh well. Hey, buddy. Need some help? No problem. Hard hat lady has your back. That's the character's official canonical name. It's Hard Hat Lady. I don't like the looks of that guy with the boomerang. So I think I'll throw a pot at him. Show him who's boss. Man, not much money on this level. Shit. This is gonna be a low scoring run, no matter how far I make it. I could use a rope and explore over there, but I only have two left, so I think I will cut my losses and just make it out of here. 5,750 gold. Pathetic. Any level where you don't make at least 10,000 gold is a waste, in my book. Of course, you know, if it's low scoring for me, it's going to be low scoring for everyone else, too. Except the people who make it, you know, way farther than I do. See if I can make it across this pond. See if I can... Nope! Oh, great! Oh, wow. Yeah, that boomerang totally had the momentum necessary to deal damage to me. What the fuck, Spelunky? What the fuck? I managed to actually make my health a little bit better, and then I just screwed it all up again. Ruby, I'll take it. Crap. Don't like the looks of that frog. Oh, hey! That is a good item to find in a crate. I'm glad I have it, because it would have been difficult for me to make it down here otherwise. Oh, wow. Spring Bush is sitting over there. That's cool. There's a crate down here, too. With the parachute. Was gonna go for that pile of gold up there, but, nah. I'm being a little bit more cautious than usual since I only have one health. One thing I never liked about this game, how random objects can damage you with seemingly no momentum. Well, practically none. Yeah, it makes me really, really nervous about throwing items around. Because you never know how it's going to, come back and potentially hit you. Alright, well, wasn't expecting to make it this far in this run. Not that that means I'm good. Actually, it means I suck. It means I'm probably going to die on this level. Because I'm not jinxing myself. Oh god. There's a freaking alien on this level too. If you can kill the alien, it's good stuff because there's always a jetpack behind him. Wow, this was... that. I did not think that plan through. Oh well. This is a pretty respectable run. 127. I mean, I'm sure that's not going to last, but, I almost did as good as Robo Dracula. It's pretty good. Well, some guy did pretty good. I was like looking through the leaderboards and seeing if there are any names that I recognize. Usually not, but I did see Bananasaurus Rex's name in here once. Alright, well, this has been Spelunky. Thanks for watching, everyone. Hey, you saw the City of Gold. I'm counting that as progress. So, yeah. Tune in next time. Probably, I don't know, maybe sometime this week. I'll do another one of these. But, won't be too long. So, yeah. Thanks for watching. See you guys later.